dumb start, you know, at that time. And people were talking about the same thing. They asked me, said, look at this, the world is going worse, crazy, everybody is each other. And I stopped, I stopped to think, I said, you know what, if you know the history, because I love history, I study and I read a lot about history, I know what's going on, what was going on. I said, if you look at the history, there is always massacre, killing, and wars, and wipe out people. Hulagu, the Mongols came to the 13th century, they wiped out all over. And then there are so many wars happened. And then I said, even one more step down, I realized in myself, oh, I said, there is a story in the Bible and Quran also, in our holy book.
Yes.
Beginning, Adam has two sons. You know, he killed this one of one son, he killed his brother because of the he wasn't angry, whatever the story is. But at the end, he killed his brother. I said, and then I said, see, at the beginning, this is the example for us. Human nature can kill. This is his nature. And but also, I realized another thing right over there, which is, I saw that like the one that who killed or the one who be killed, I liken it is just like a Bush and Saddam. One people behind the Saddam, one another kind of people behind Bush. They are just attacking and killing each other. But I say that is Adam was looking at his son. His son killed his son, and then did he kill his son? No, because he had a father consciousness. And of course, he had to teach him a manner, discipline, whatever, but he cannot kill his son. So I said, when we have to look at the situation, we must have the Adam consciousness, father consciousness. We shouldn't kill each other. We shouldn't fight with each other. This is the fundamental example for us. And two examples, people only see this killing, but they forget. But also, they never realize that Adam is exists in us. We have to look each other with the fatherhood or motherhood, like with the sympathy, with the mercy, you know. Because this is what I feel. That's what I say. This is condition gain us from God to condition us, to challenge us. Or even another story like Adam, when Adam was created and he was in heaven alone, and with Eve created after that, but they were bored. So they needed to be challenged. So if there is no dark, how can we know the white, the light, you know? There are so many examples about it. That's why God says, you didn't see yourself when you were alone, but now I created dark so you can see yourself and use it. Because they say, dark is not exist. As soon as you turn the light, dark disappears. So there is no light, then there is a dark. But as soon as you direct the light, where dark is, and dark disappears. So in this way, I should answer your question as, oh, what is going on? And I say this is condition for us, for the artist, for human being. If there is no conflict, where is our challenge? So I see this always as a challenge. And individually, unfortunately, people think to correcting the world, just the preaching and then telling the others. But all the mysticism and all the mystics and Sufis, they say, only thing you got to change is you. When you change yourself individually, since you are belong to society, and society will earn one person. And this way, you will be example. And people see you rather than hear and imagine what is this supposed to be. So this is the Sufi approach, being an example. Also, that's many, many teachings. They say this too. Be example, not the preacher, you know.
Can you say something about the Sufis and give a context for who the Sufis are? Because I think you know better. I know about them. I've read many books about them. But I really think you could translate. Who are they? Because they have huge influence all over the world in a mystical way, in a really good way. Tell us, what do they do?
Actually, as a what they feel, what they think, even though the Sufism flourished through Islam, but it exists in every religion, who is the adoration of God, the Creator. So for myself, I summarize what Sufi is. I say two things I can define who Sufi is. The one who adores the Lord, the one Creator, and then second one, and loves all the creatures because of the Creator. So they are full of love, and then they accept everything because of the reflection of the Lord and His manifestation. They don't criticize. They try to see the wisdom in behind every aspect of life. So they are full of contentment. They are full of love and acceptance also. They don't criticize because they think everything has its own destiny. None of people's destiny is alike. Happiness and peace is our destiny, but how to go there is unique. Every individual has his own path to finding the truth, they say. Even Muhammad said, God bless, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, God is. So he said that there are as many paths as people goes to God. So the Sufi is the one who adores the Creator and then loves the Creator, creation because of the Creator. So this is what I should say about it.
What are your personal challenges, if there are for you right now, that you are comfortable and maybe willing to share with us? Because you've been doing music since you were a little boy, and there's all kinds of challenges being a musician, particularly a Middle Eastern musician in this world. And yet, it's been a long ride, hasn't it? It's been a long journey to get here, where you're finally, you've always been well-received, but finally, even that music, that song, that space, people want it more and more.
Well, all my life, I was always aware of the blessing that God is already giving. And with the Sufism, I became more aware of that the truth, that only thing that I should ask, where I am already, to keep where I am. Because in the ultimate sense, they say there is only one struggle, there is one loser, one gainer. The losing is, the struggle is being in the present, because there is no place, there is no God. God is present everywhere. Our consciousness, we get away from it. Just like the sun, we are in the room, we close the curtain, we don't see the sun. But sun is still there. It doesn't disappear. So we don't see it. So the challenge is always feeling that you are in the present. We are in the present. With all the worries and unnecessary thinking, we take ourselves into the dark and get away from this light, get this present, and then this is the struggle. That's what I say, my Lord, I am asking you, only you, as one of the great saints, Yunus said. He said, I don't ask your heaven. I am not afraid your hell. I want you. I want you. I want you. Only thing he wants, the presence of God, he wants to do. This is the ultimate thing. Struggle, like you said, because of this presence, feeling that everything is already beautiful. Everything is already blessing us. Life is bestowing us all this beautiful, everything we have. But unfortunately, we are in the luxury because it's like crisis. What crisis? Crisis is for the luxury. Our necessities, what we necessarily have to survive, we have already. People, they crisis, economic crisis, for the luxury. So what I mean is, we are already blessed. We are already having so much from life. God is giving us to everything. So I'm just, my struggle is just to keep in where I am already, not to get away from this blessing. Because I know at the end we have certain time in this body and then we will go. But our consciousness, our feelings has to be